welcome. My name is Kia and I'm coming to you from Sweden in a small village outside of Gothenburg. This is my podcast where I share with you my crafty life. I'm a knitter, a spinner, and sometimes I do other crafts as well. In this podcast I will share with you some finished objects, some ongoing projects. I have done some stitching and some spinning, and there will also be a small giveaway today in this episode, so stay tuned if you are interested in some of these things. On social medias I am Kia Spod _ podcast on Instagram and on Ravelry. I have a website, kiaspod.se, where I put up this link I put up this video with links to everything I talk about today. So I hope that you will enjoy some of the content that I have here for you today. I am on Patreon and on Ko-fi if you want to support my work with this channel. I'm back in the greenhouse and it feels so good. I love to sit out here because, yeah, it's good lighting and it's not so warm. I feel a good temperature out here. And yeah, it's so cozy. I feel really creative out here with all the glasses and the things around me. It feels more like me and my podcast than when I sit indoors. So I took the opportunity today because it's a cloudy day and no raining, and I thought it's good to sit out here. If it's raining I can't really be here because it's too loud on the plastic roof here. So today is perfect. It's Saturday and in Sweden we are having a weekend. It's called All Saints Day. It's like you have Halloween, but that was last weekend. In Sweden we have this All Saints Day. It's like we go to the cemetery, you call it that, the church, the grave with all the grave, and we light the candle. And yeah, this weekend is a weekend to remember all the passed away relatives or friends that we have. So we will go later this afternoon. We will go to my mother and father-in-law, their grave, and we will light the candle. So that's something that we do here in Sweden. And the weekend is sort of a reminder to think about the past away ones. I'm not sure if you have the same where you live, but this is the weekend. So free. I have been home with a cold this week, so I'm in the end of a cold, but the Swedish episode went well with no coughing and nothing, so I'm hoping that this one will go well also. And shall we start to talk about what I am wearing, because I'm so happy. A stone has been lifted from my chest. I have finally finished the second version of my Stripey Heaven. Earlier this year I went up to my handspun yarn and I found a lot of similar thickness in my handspun yarn stash. And I pulled out a lot of different ones and I just knitted that sweater, and it came from my head and from my heart and from inspiration of the yarns and just knitting and not writing anything down, just knitting and feeling happy. And afterwards I was sort of finished with it, you know, when you knit a sweater and you're full with inspiration and you just want, but when you're done and you just want to move on. So there was no inspiration to sit and write down the pattern then, and I decided that no, this will not be a pattern. But earlier this autumn when I finished this spin, because the bottom color here is also a handspun yarn, and that's all of it is handspun yarn, and yeah, I decided that perhaps I will do another version, not the same, because knitting the same thing twice is not so inspiring. So when I came up with the idea of making a second version with only two colors and change the body here and do a different style of the sweater, I was really inspired. And I decided that this time I will take the time to write down the pattern and to provide it for my patrons, because I'm so, so grateful for those of you who are patrons and support my work. And I feel like I don't give enough back. It always feels like I get so much from you, and I don't feel like I give you anything back. So I feel really happy now to have this pattern written down and to provide it for my patrons. I'm forever grateful for you, because you make me keep on sharing, because otherwise it's easy just to sit at home and perhaps create, and you don't really share it with anybody. And yeah, this way, because of you, I feel so, so grateful. And yeah, happy to have a pattern for you. And I did two versions. This one is a little bit different in both gauge and style. That one was knitted in 2.5 millimeter needles for the cuffs and the neckline and the details, and 3 millimeter for all the body. And this one is knitted in 3 millimeter needles for the eye cord and the edge, the ribbings, and 3.5 millimeter needles for the body. I have a bird in here and he is wondering where the food is. I haven't had the time to feed the birds yet, so he's in here telling me that it's empty. But he will have to wait. Yes, the second version is a little bit thicker in yarn, and also I did long sleeves on this one, and that's 3/4 length sleeves, and this is long sleeves, and body is same length. And I was worried the last podcast, I had it like this, if you remember, it flipped up. But after blocking, if you knit this sweater and you know, it's knitted top down, and you come to when you bind off the eye cord at the edge at the bottom here, don't worry if it flips up, because it after blocking it will lay really, really nicely. So there is no, it has no tendency to flip up now. So that was something that was before blocking. And Agnes is laying here, listening to me talking English. And if she is on the stative here, it's only Agnes. It's nothing to worry about. She wants to be where I am. And yeah, I don't know if there is anything else to tell you about this sweater. It's only for patrons. It only comes in one size. I never do my patterns in all the sizes, because I don't do test knits and all the things. And it feels really weird to write down different sizes if I don't have them tested. I can only tell you what I have done here and write it down in the pattern. And yeah, there is some interesting things in this sweater, and the eye cord cast on and starting on this sweater is something, it's not the normal, regular thing that you do. So I think that if you are one of my patrons, you will find this start interesting. And please pay attention. Don't do what I did the first time when I forgot to do the increases here after the eye cord, because that way I ended up with a cone, and now I ended up with a perfectly fitting yoke. There is no strange things happening when I lift my arms, and I can, yeah, it's worth doing it one more time when you end up with a nice fitted sweater. So That's Agnes. For the first time in a very, very long time, I can show you some pictures of a finished sweater. I don't think I have had any finished sweater since sometimes this summer. And it hasn't been a year where I have been so focused on sweater knitting. I have been spinning a lot this year. And the work situation has changed a little bit, so I work more, and I also started to take this course, and time has been splitted into other things this year. I used to end up with 30 sweaters knitted every year, and I don't think I have 10, perhaps 10 with this one, I don't remember, but around 10 sweaters this year, and it feels like I have slowed down a little bit and perhaps be a little bit more mindful of what I make and think twice. Okay, let's have a look at the fantastic pictures that my husband took of me modeling both these sweaters. Agnes was so kind to model a little bit with me as well, and I always feel strange in front of the camera, and it feels like I have nothing to do and I feel awkward, but when one of the dogs are with me when we take the pictures, I feel like I'm natural with them. I have something to do. When you just stand in front of the camera and you shall look happy and you shall look... Now, it's a little bit strange. But with the dogs, it always feels good. So that's the Stripey Heaven sweater. And if you are one of my patrons and you wonder where to find all my patterns, when you come to the first site on the Patreon, when you are a patron, and you can search for pattern, and you will get all the patterns coming up. I have tagged all the patterns, so if you are searching for something special, just search for a tag, and I have tagged for patterns, videos, Easter, and so on. So if there is something you're looking for, and also the name of the sweaters, you can search for and you will find them. Because on Patreon, as far as I have understood it, it's only one long feed of posts. But Well, I did do the work a couple of months ago, and I went back and I tagged all my posts, so it will be easy for you to search, so you don't have to scroll down and look for yourself. So if you are looking for Stripey Heaven, you can write Stripey Heaven or pattern. You will get all the patterns and so on. So that's for my patrons. And I also want to say that you can join in any level, from the smallest amount and to the highest amount, and you will get the same content, because I don't want to make a change from if you can offer more or not. I want everybody to be able to join in. Oh, Agnes is moving the camera now. She feels it's not enough space here. She's settled in now. So, okay, in any level that you join in on Patreon, you will get the same content. And yeah, this time I feel like I have something really special to offer. The lighting changed. I'm not sure if this is good or bad. Okay. That's the Stripey Heaven sweater, and let's move on to the second thing that I have finished. And I told you last week that I finished my handspun socks, and I'm almost ashamed to show them to you, because I have been wearing them a lot. And yeah, this is the socks that I knitted from my handspun yarn, and I have now added heels on both of them. So there is heels in. It's a little bit thicker. Sorry, it's dog hair, and I have been wearing them so much. But I did afterthought heel, and I just I took the needle in on one line of the stitches, and left one line of stitches, and then another needle in on this line here, and then I cut in the middle of the stitch line that was in between the needles. I cut in the middle there, and then I just ripped out. I moved a little bit, perhaps she won't bump into the camera. Then I ripped out from the middle of the stitch, because if you cut in the end here, it's easy that it will keep on ripping out. But if you cut in the middle of the line between the needles, it's you have long ends to weave in, so I think that's good. Afterthought heel on this one, and I also did do some stitching here. I'm so ashamed to put the clothes, they have been used. I did do some reinforcement here with weaving on the green ones here, and then I did, just for fun, I did duplicate stitch. Do you call it that when you stitch in the stitches? Is that duplicate stitch? I think so. So I just did the triangular here, because this is where I often wear out my socks, and I thought, why not use this orange just to bind it a little bit together with the rest of the sock. So a little bit more orange, and it looks really nice. And I also did some embroidery on the back. And that is because some of you commented that you thought of the grapevine leaf that I was showing you a couple of, maybe 1 month ago, I'm not sure. And I thought that why not just make some dots here, like grapes. And it binds only on the back, not on the front. And it binds together the heel and also the mending here. So, this sock is now done, and I did use up the full kit of the handspun. It was 100 grams of the green, and it was 20 grams of the white, and I had to add this orange for the heel, because it was I had no more handspun. And they became quite long in the leg here, so if I would have done it one more time, perhaps with this this amount of fibers, I would have done a little bit shorter on the leg and instead add that yarn to the heel. But it's also very nice with this contrasting color. So yeah, really, really happy with this pair of handspun yarn, handspun socks. When I finished them, I started to wear them at once. So I had them for a couple of days and then I realized that, oh no, I should have kept them nice for you and show you first. But yeah, that's life. I also wear my things that I knit, and yeah, these pairs got worn before I had the time to show them to you. So that's one finished sock, and I also have a second pair finished, and this is my Robin socks that I told you that I got inspired and ordered from England. Stupid me, they cost me so much. But I have realized that I will get four pairs of socks because I ordered two skeins, and this way I used up 50 grams of the color for the from this, and 20 grams from the cuffs, heels and toes, and I can get four pairs out of two skeins. So that's if you divide the money in four, it's not so much. So that feels a little bit better. But yes, I finished my Robin socks, and I love the color combinations with this red and rust and brown, and yeah, it's really beautiful. And I think I can sort of get away with this, since it's on my feet, I can have them matching with this sweater. Yeah, really nice. And yeah, these pairs of socks I have beside the computer when I was watching, doing some schoolwork, and there is lectures and so on the computer. So when I was watching, and I also took class when we just sit talk, I can knit on this. So I have now come one pair of sock into my class, into my course, and I have started up a second pair, but I forgot to bring them. They are just stripy leftover socks. I love the stripy socks, and they come so quickly. I don't have to think when I knit socks, and yeah, you can do a lot of fancy socks, but I prefer to use my time, my brain space for other things. Socks should be just relaxing for me, and stripy socks is just the perfect thing. So there is now the Robin socks finished, and I am really happy with them. Just knitting 2.25 millimeter needles, 64 stitches, and yeah, same recipe every time. Not anything new there, same. One small thing that I also have finished is a pair of just the ribbings for my husband, and he is wearing his sweater that I knitted to him in March. It was a colorwork sweater. It's sort of like this, with the colorwork in the yoke and dots on the body, and also with this corrugated ribbing at the end. And he has a brown sort of mocha. You call it mocha, I'm not sure. It's a hard wearing jacket, and it's a little bit short in the sleeves. So when he wears his sweater under this jacket, it's just perfect. He thinks it looks so good with the ribbing sticking out under the jacket. So he asked me, Kia, could we make perhaps just some cuffs for this jacket, and not so when I don't wear the sweater under, they will still have this beautiful cuff sticking out under the jacket. And I said, of course we can do so. So I knitted two cuffs and a little bit here, and I will attach on the lining of the jacket, and he will have just this in the jacket sticking out, and it will be really nice, I think. I'm hesitating because I'm thinking, what if he wants to wear the sweater as well as the jacket with this attached on. So I'm thinking perhaps I should just add some buttons, and he could, if he wants to wear the sweater under the jacket, he can just take these away. And if he wants to wear the jacket without the sweater, he can have these on. So I will talk a little bit more about that with him, so we can make a decision together. But something that was so interesting when I made this, we took them beside the sweater that he has been wearing for, what, I don't know, 8 months. And the other one was really, really dirty. This one is light gray, and that one was almost like dark gray. And I said to my husband, we must hang this one out and see if it self cleans itself. Wool does that, you know, when you hang it out, it sort of cleans itself. So we hang the sweater outdoors for a couple of days and took it in, and no, that didn't work, because I think it only if, you know, it's a little bit sweaty perhaps, or if there is something, it feels fresh after hanging out 2 days, but it wasn't clean, it wasn't. So I think we will have to do this in the washing machine, or at least put it in some kind of bath. What was interesting when he took off this sweater, it's knitted in Swedish wool from Järbo, and he has been wearing it, like I said, every day since March. And when he hung this one out for 2 days, he jumped into his riddari that I knitted for him in Lättloopi. And I think it took like I don't know, a couple of minutes, and he said, oh my god, this sweater is so warm. So there is a difference between the Swedish wool, it's the same thickness, but the fiber content is different, of course. It's Swedish wool blend, and this Icelandic wool is so warm. So he reacted. I'm not that sensitive, because I feel warm. I'm oversensitive perhaps, because I feel warm every time in wool sweater, it's warm. But he was wearing this one for so long, and when he got into the Lättloopi sweater, he felt immediately that it was much warmer. So that made me actually bring out a sweater's quantity that I had in my stash of the Swedish wool, because I thought, if this one is not so warm than Lättloopi, I can perhaps wear a cardigan in that. So we shall see what I will make. I have winded up it in skeins, and perhaps I will do some swatching. I would like to knit it in a quite loose gauge, so it also will be a little bit airy. But we shall see. And the story of these cuffs will, I will let you know how we will do with it. But I think it's clever to be able to take them away if he wants to wear the sweater under the jacket as well. So just a small thing, but it led up to both experimenting with cleaning wool outdoors and also comparing different yarns and everything. So that's nice. I have now completed the cuffs for him. So no more finished object today. I showed you in the previous podcast that I was knitting on a sweater from this book. Erika Åberg, a Swedish designer, and she came out with this book, From Coast to Coast. She has been traveling a lot from Shetland, and also she lives on Gotland here, and when she grew up, she also grew up on, she had a summer house on another Swedish island. So there is a lot of islands that she has got inspiration from, and I found one sweater in this book that's called Tong. And you are always so good at giving me the right words when I'm hesitating for words. And tong was the plant that is washed up from the ocean that always lies on the beach. And nobody said differently, so I'm not sure what you call it. We call it tong. And this sweater is called tong. And I knitted it in a thread of linen and hold super soft and holding them together with a broken rib stitch. Yeah, it's really nice, and I have actually completed the body. It will be a short body, like a cropped body. And last night I finished the sleeves and the one sleeve, and I'm now knitting on the second sleeve. So this one will soon be off the needles. And this is what I have. This is the golden linen yarn on a cone, and this is the whole super soft, what I think, because this one I bought second hand, so I'm not quite sure. There is nothing writing on it, so, but it acts like a whole super soft. It's a really thin wool thread, so holding these two together will get a really nice fabric that I can wear indoors. So I'm happy for this sweater, and I'm really excited to see how it will end up when I give it a bath and a wash and everything. So we shall see how it will end up. This one is from Kasthall in Kinna, here a village where I live. So, linen and wool combination, and I'm running out of the linen yarn, so we shall see. I'm sure I can do the sleeves, but when I tried this one on, the sleeves are a little bit short. And you know, when you put on a sweater and the sleeves are a little bit short, they tend to stretch a little bit here in the neckline. So you can see here, they are similar like this, but when I put it on, they sort of stretch a little bit. So the neckline looks like this when I wear it. So when I have finished this sleeve, I will, if the yarn is, I still have yarn, I will do this sleeve a little bit longer and then pick up and do this sleeve a little bit longer, because it sits much better on the yoke if the sleeves are not pulling it down like this. So yeah, that's something. I'm not sure for how long I will have the linen yarn here, so that's why I did like this. And yeah, it's not perfect, but I will probably have to do this sleeve one more time. The split hem is interesting, because you did do the back a little bit into the front piece, and then when you did the front ribbing, you picked up stitches over the back ribbing here, so it lays over, and that's a good thing, because I don't really like split hems, because they make a gap, and this way they are there and they give interest, but they don't gap. This one is keeping it close. So this detail I really, really like. And this sweater, I'm hoping for this sweater to be a good size. I'm not sure about the color. Is this a color for me or not? I'm not sure. I have stopped coloring my hair. I'm not sure if you have been thinking about that. But before summer, somewhere in April, May, there, I always stop to dye my hair, because summer comes and sun comes and everything, and it always just bleach it down again. And now I have decided, I have not yet dyed it, and I am gray in here. Here you can see, this is how far I have been. I have been not dying, and it's not that it's dark, it's more like it's golden or something out here, but it will be gray. And I asked when I went to cut my hair the last time, it was a while, I know, if she just could dye it gray, the whole thing, so I didn't have to do this growing out. But she said it's not possible, because I have to bleach everything down and then dye it gray, and then I will have some kind of grow out anyway, so we shall see. But the thing I wanted to come to is that my color palette is changing. I think I used to look good in like this golden yellow, but I'm not sure now with the new hair coming out. We shall see. I can always put a strong colored scarf around it just to mark it. But yes, that's one sweater on the needles from the Swedish designer Erika Åberg. The second sweater on the needles are from another Swedish designer, Maja Karlsson. And from this book I picked a full colorwork sweater. So one solid color from one book and one colorwork from the other book. And I'm not sure if I have been knitting anything on this sweater since the previous podcast, because I did finish this one and I have knitted a lot on the other yellow one. But I knit something here and there on this one. This is good on the hands. The linen and the Holst combination is not so good on the hands. I get quite tired in my wrists when I knit the linen yarn for a long time. So I have been knitting a little bit on this, but yeah, I don't know. Not much, I think. But it's a fantastic color combination with the gray and the brown. And the yarn I am using is Luna by Permin. It's a recycled wool, and in the Swedish episode someone commented that it pills a lot, this yarn. But I have no experience from it, so we shall see if it will. But yeah, it's a really soft yarn now and it feels really good. And combining it with the Baby Merino is a good combination. So it will be a soft, nice sweater when it's done. And I'm so tempted to cast on for the sleeves, because there was an interesting detail where I can knit my monograms on the sleeves and also the year I'm knitting it. So that's really tempting to start. But I want to finish the yellow one now before working more on this sweater. So I will have to wait with that a little bit. Last year I was so inspired by an Instagram account called Marita Rolin. She is a Swedish, she is a crafter, but she also has a web shop and she is selling a lot of sashiko kits and yarns and all the things. And she was doing 24 days of sashiko last year, and I was so inspired and I wanted to do that, and I found it too late, so I couldn't join in last year. So this year, when I saw that Sashiko Lab was hosting this 24 days of Sashiko one more time this year, I decided to join in. And it has been so relaxing to embroider, or do you say embroider, to stitch some Sashiko every day. And this is what it looks like. Small patches of sashiko stitch every day. And there has been, I'm not sure now, I don't remember, are we on day 12 perhaps? I'm not sure. But when I saw this in time, I joined her email. I'm not sure, I think it's time has run out now for this year, but follow Sashiko Lab on Instagram and you will get notified for the next year if you want to join in and just do some small stitching every day. And it has been so relaxing. It don't take long, just like perhaps 15 minutes or something, and it's really really fun. And the way she has built up the stitches over the days here is that you start with a simple stitch. And then the next day she adds some lines of stitches for the pattern, and it totally changed the patterns. So I decided to go for three colors. I had brown, I had beige, and I had green. And those were the colors that I went for in my patches. And now the rain starts. I hope it won't disturb you on the roof. So there is three different colors on the linen fabric, and I also have three different colors on the thread. I have rust for the beige patch, I have light blue for the brown patch, and I have beige for the green patch. So they will be three different kinds of color combinations of patches, and really, really enjoying this. And as I said, Marita Rolin is the Swedish person I was inspired by. Sashiko Lab is the host of this 24 days of Sashiko. And a while back I showed you, I remember, that I bought some, what do you call this? We call it mall. And from this, it's hard plastic with stencils, perhaps you call this. And the day before this Sashiko, 24 days of Sashiko started, I sat down and I cut out the squares, and I did do these drawings with this stencil. So we should do 1 centimeter between the lines here, the squares, and that meant that I did do the drawings from not every line here, but every second line, and I did all the little squares here on this. So first I did these lines, and then I just twisted the stencil, and I could add. So I have a grid, we call it rutor, rutmönster in Swedish, but you call it a grid of squares. And I have prepared my little pile here of squares that I will be stitching on, and I have done those, and I have done, let's see here, there is 4 more here. So yes, I am behind. I haven't done this day's Sashiko yet, because I wanted to go out and podcast for catching the daylight. But yeah, at first I did it in the morning, but now it has become an evening routine. So I think tonight I will sit down and stitch today's grid. And a really, really nice little stitching. She did an advent calendar. She sewed small bags and for her kids to put in something for the advent calendar. That's why it's 24 days. And yeah, you can do advent calendar, you can do under the glass on the table, you can do patchwork, you can do mending patches, because I saw that Marita Rolin, the Swedish webshop, she had got big fabrics with small squares, and she called them mending patches. So you cut out a square and you use it for mending your clothes. So you can do a lot of things with these small squares, but right now I am just enjoying the stitches, and I'm not so worried about if this will become something or not, because I had the fabric lying around, and I had the thread, and I have the 15 minutes every day just to enjoy doing some stitching. And some days I just feel like they end too quickly, so I bring out some other Sashiko project that I have laying, so I stitch a little bit extra on those as well. So that's the Sashiko that I have been doing, and I'm so enjoying doing this every day. There has also been some spinning, and I am joining my friend Emma this autumn for her fiber club, and the theme has been the desert. And I just took out the three fibers that we have got every month. So the first month was this radnor that she dyed, and I spun it and did a chain ply. So it's the three threads with the chain plied yarn and knitted socks. The second month it was sand was the theme, and it's Falkland Merino. It's super soft, really, really nice. And this one I have spun now since the last podcast. I have done this, not the Icelandic wool that I wanted to, but I did this instead. I wanted to try some of these fibers from the Fiber Club as well. So I ended up with 600 meters of this 200 gram fiber. So it's really, really good. And I think it's washing me out. So I will knit it with something with a stronger color in. So it will not be the only color. And this November colorway is Hägring. You know, when you're walking in the desert and you think you're starting to see things and they're not there. In Sweden they're called Hägring. I'm not sure what you call it in English. The thing that you think you see water when you walk in the desert, but when you come up there, there is nothing. So, yeah. And this was a blend of white-faced woodland something, and Raimi and viscose and llama. So there was a lot of content, both plant and the animal fibers in this. And this is... I will not spin that one now because it feels a little bit more like something for summer. But you could also spin for socks with that one. We shall see. So these are the three colorways in the Fiber Club that I have been joining. And Emma is also doing advent calendar now for December. And she is also releasing a striped sock kit. You know, I told you that we were talking a little bit when I spun up this with the contrasting fibers and also spinning for the sock. But now she has dyed different colors. So there will be possibility for you to stripe your own way and combine it like you want to. And yeah, it will be fun. So that's something that's coming up really soon from Emma. Yeah. And Agnes, do you want to say hi? No, you don't see her. She is getting tired now. We have been out here for a long time and it's getting time to wrap it up. But I told you the previous podcast that I wanted to give one of you a tea calendar. So this is the Pukka Organic Tea Calendar for December. And I will draw one from the Swedish and one from this English podcast. And I have also decided, since there was a lot of you thinking that the unfinished object calendar for December was a good idea, I have also decided that we will do that. It will be so fun. So it will be Kia's UFO calendar hashtag. And we use it on Instagram. And what I want you to do now is come with suggestions on how to do this unfinished object calendar. Shall we do small, you know, you write down on small notes and put in a bowl and then draw one every day and you will write on that note all of your unfinished objects, one on each note, and then just draw one. Or shall we write down a list and work our way from? Or shall we come up with ideas? And just let me know under here how to work this unfinished object calendar. And let's do it in December. It will be good for all of us to clean up the unfinished objects that we have and be fresh for the new year. I think it's really, really good. And you will get the chance to win one of these Pukka tea calendars for December. I have one for myself as well. And I bought a surprise for my husband. He will get a tea calendar. And he will, of course, share it with me. So we will have a new cup of coffee every... Did I say tea? I meant coffee calendar for him and tea calendar for me. But I will make that coffee for both of us in the morning. So we shall see. But tea calendars for you. And please just comment under here. I thought today would be really, really nice to end this podcast with pictures of every day of this 24 days of Sashiko. And yeah, so you can have a little bit closer up a look. And I will also, I have started on Instagram on the highlights, you call it that, on my profile. I have started with 24 days of Sashiko. So if you're interested to go and have a look at the small patches, you can go there, and I have saved all of them. I have not yet, but I will save all of the 24 patches on my highlights. And yeah, I hope that you will enjoy to have a little look here at all the patches that I have done. If you want to support my work with this channel, there will be links under here to coffee.com and to Patreon. And for my patrons, you will get now this pattern for the Stripey Heaven sweater. And I hope that you will enjoy. And some of you are looking through your handspun and want to get started. And I'm so looking forward to see what you will make. And it's so, so special to knit from your handspun. But if you're not a hand spinner, there is other fingering. I'm sure you have a lot of fingering yarn laying around. And also sport weight yarn is a good length for this sweater. So have a lovely time now, and I will see you again really soon. And I'm not sure with the drawings of these tea calendars, perhaps I will reply and let you know under this. I will get in contact in the comments under the video, so we will have time to ship out to you, so you will have it for the 1st of December. We shall see. If I'm quick and record a new episode, perhaps it will be in that. Have a lovely time. Bye-bye.